Hello and welcome. I am Raghav and welcome to this episode of Ask Raghav. I hope all of you are doing awesome and are very good. And today I have a very interesting question about conflicts between dev and QA. And the question is, in real-time environment, there are some conflicts between dev and QA teams frequently. And my query is, as a DevOps guy, how can I solve these conflicts and how can we make them do work together in a healthy way. So thank you for your question, and I will tell you some general things and some technical things, because you said that you are a DevOps guy, so the answer actually lies in DevOps. But let me start with some general things, that if you are having these conflicts and very often you see all these issues coming between dev and QA teams, the very first thing that you can do right away is, before you go to a technical solution, you can do is effective communication. And when I say effective communication, it is how exactly you present your idea or your views. For example, as a QA, if you found an issue or a defect, instead of just pinpointing a developer that you made a mistake and you did this and you did not code and you missed the functionality and all this, you can just log the defect and in your description just say that this is what I found. Please analyze and check if my finding is correct, and then you can add all your findings and whatever you have observed. So this is kind of a more better way to communicate, and this is how you can start with. Now coming to the technical solution, I believe and I have observed that most of these issues and conflicts between dev and QA is because the QA checks and tests something and finds the issue, and the dev says that this is all working fine on my environment, my machine, I coded for it, I added all the functionality, so you check your system and your environment. And this is actually true. A lot of time it happens that the issue is because dev is using a different environment than QA. They have different environment and different configuration, and this is what causes the issue and the defects, and therefore both are correct in their own ways. Dev says everything is working fine on their system and the QA says that they found a defect. Now a very simple solution is, we should have the replicas of these two environment, dev and QA. They should have all the same settings, all the same configurations, so that we can minimize all such conflicts. And then today we have so many other solutions. Being a DevOps guy, you can look for solutions like Docker, where we actually package the application along with all its libraries and all the environment and all the settings, so that we can set it up on any system, any environment, and we can be sure that the application has everything it requires to run it. And if you still get an issue, it is mostly because of some functional issue or some functional defect. So these are all the things that we can add into our organization. Both the general solutions and the technical solutions will work together and resolve and minimize most of these dev and QA conflicts. I hope this was useful for you. If you have any other question for the next episode of Ask Raghav, please let me know in the comment section below and I will take it up, and I will see you soon. Thank you for watching, and never stop learning.